it's really exciting that we're releasing the new five-year RD&E plan on behalf of GRDC and the sector. It really provides a roadmap on the way in which we're going to invest, who we're going to invest with, and also informs the risk appetite in which we're actually pursuing our investments. Growers expect us to be taking some risk on their behalf to ensure that we look for those step change innovations to deliver to growers. And out of anyone in the sector to do that, growers expect us to do that. And this new plan is articulating we will take a little more risk in the portfolio. An investment that's made today pays off not just for next year, but for 5, 10, 15, 20 years. And it's extremely powerful that every investment we make is effectively a foundational investment, and then we just build on that. And that is to ensure that we support the farmers, the men and women who are farming our great land and also looking after the country and ensuring their communities are long-term viable. This plan has taken 18 months to develop. So we've actually gone through a very iterative process to actually develop the plan, consult with growers, consultants, research partners, international players. We've had hundreds and hundreds of engagements, including an all-grower survey. 20,000 of our growers could have provided intel into the survey, and many did. So this 18-month process has now run its course, and we've landed on a very good place with regards to the new RD&E plan between 2023 and 2028. With the new plan, it's really showing that our business partners are changing. So the people in which GRDC would traditionally invest in are now, we're diversifying. So our traditional partners will still be there, but there's no doubt there's innovation and technology being driven by the private sector, not just nationally, but globally. We need to make sure that we are front of house. We are the door that those people come through. So we have initiatives like Grain Innovate, where we're actually literally investing in angel early stage investments in small startups to ensure that we've got innovation technology coming to growers quicker and faster. One of the big challenges coming at us at the moment is market expectation and also community expectation around sustainability. So we need to make sure that we get bang for buck for any input that we put in to make the most efficient, and also develop technologies around ensuring that that occurs somehow. But we also need to demonstrate to our markets that we are running sustainable systems. So when it comes to emissions and carbon sequestration in your country, that is an area that GRDC is now applying as part of its farming systems approach. I am very excited to see the next plan come to fruition. The new plan is simpler, very clear in its articulation, with four very clear pillars. Doesn't matter what size or scale of business you have, you need to ensure you've got focus, you prioritise, and we utilise our growers and our panel network and our team to prioritise what we should be investing in. And it's actually very exciting to get this out the gate and get the new strategy moving.